that we go through many difficulties in life. You know, and then when we came to Philippines and started in ATS, we struggled with finance. We do not have anyone supported, and still now we do not have any support. But if we see now that I can see God's hand so actively. Now it's so frustrating, and then after I was praying to God, pouring out and crying to God, and I never saw a reason in my life with open eyes, but that time I saw a reason. And that reason was like this: so many hands, you know, from the wall, here wall, here wall, and hand like this. So many hands. Down there was fire, so big fire. And I was in this hand. And then, you know, this hand took me to the other hand. This hand took to the other hand. And that hands were helping me to cross those fire areas. I saw in my open eye, I never saw. That was my first experience. I never saw that kind of experience. Then I realized that, okay, even though we go through fire, God is going to provide us so many hands. I don't know who. I did not see the face, but I saw many hands, you know. And then that promise God keeps. It was not my mind story. I thought that time it was my mind story. I could not believe, though I feel very comfort, but I could not believe. So, but when I see after 2.5 years back, we never lack anything. No one promised us until now. But every time our bill is paid there by someone. Sometimes 10,000, sometimes 20,000. And they did not even give name. You know, okay. Sushil Sharma paid for Madhuri this much amount. No, even no names. So they give. And every time, you know, our account, the payment for our school, always God provide. So that reason, you know, God still holding now. If we were not able to pay, we might not be here now. I might not stand here in front of you and preaching. But because God valued that reason, God gave me assurance. Now I can see that He fulfilled that promise. My third point, I'm sorry, I just did a bit long. This will be my third point, is that God has always been at work in your life. Because this one I can say guarantee, because we have experienced so many things, but recently we experienced one amazing thing. For our visa, we have to go to Manila to apply Korean visa, and still my husband and me went to Manila. But when we reached to the bus station, when we see our bag was so wet, you know, all wet water in our bag, and we put all our documents in our bag. Amen. And then here in verse 4 it says that even though the bus station and then we saw that one. Oh wow, God protected. Otherwise, you know, that hill, the water, you know, for us it was like very tough time. So it can destroy our passport, if it destroy our passport, then we might not be able to go anywhere. If it destroy our invitation letter from Korea, we might not get again that letter original. But original, nothing happened, and I remember this Bible verse. God said that even the mountain will make flat. Even though we saw that difficulties, He made it flat. He made it easy. And so long story actually, but we went to the immigration office. They don't allow us to enter inside because they say office is already closed. And then after, when I tried to pursue them. I said, please, we came from far, so we have to go back tonight. So please allow us. But He did not allow. But after some time, I think God used the guards. Per day, and only 250 people can enter. Are you among 250? I said, no, I'm not. I just come to inquire. Say, oh my, so if you come inside, why don't you try to apply for a visa? I said, oh, really, we can apply? He said, yeah, no one, they don't allow to come inside, and since you are already inside, go and try. See, God provided a lady, and we went to the counter, the first counter lady received us. She said, okay, I'm sorry that you do not have a car, so first bring car and come back again, then apply to the visa. But then we line up, and then the person, he sent us to another lady, and she treat us very well. If she said that, okay, you have this documents, and do this, that, she say very nice, then we come back. And when we think that, if that lady, the Filipino lady, if she did not ask us to line up, we might come back and we don't know what the requirements are. But God used that day. See, don't know God used her. But I know that God used her to bless us. And I know that God used to bless us, that God used that guard to bless us, come inside. If He don't allow us to go inside, we might not know what are the requirements. You know? So God is so good. There are so many things happen, but I would like to share this time because I already told you a lot. But this is what happened to us. And it was in reality, the Bible made it clear that God has been at work in your life before you were born. You know, and God was at work before we go to Manila. He prepared that lady, He prepared the heart of God, He prepared another person also when we were there. So He prepared so many people to reach out our destination in Manila. So God is so good. So if we read Psalm 139:13, 15 and 16, it says, you made all the delicate inner part of my body, knit me together in my mother's womb. You washed me as I was being formed in utter solution, and I was woven together in the darkness of the womb. You found me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. God recorded every moment of your life. He captured every scene of your life. He put you on this earth not simply to live a life, but to live a life knowing Him. Not only knowing about Him, okay? Not simply knowing about Him, but it is not enough. But God wants us to have relationship with Him. Many people know about Jesus. Okay, Jesus, oh yeah, died on the cross. But they do not have personal relationship like you and us. So this is what our purpose in this, one of the purpose in this world. He wants to have personal relationship with each other, like a father and son or daughter. So He loves us so much. I want to skip some of the things. So I want to say also that God just doesn't meet you in your mother's womb. You know, He did not just meet you in your mother's womb. And He said, oh well, okay, good luck. I hope you will figure it out. Or I hope you can do anything you want. He did not say that. But He was. The Bible said, because God also gave me Isaiah 41, our right hand. So hold on, God is there. He's holding you. He did not just leave you. Okay, I already meet you in your mother's womb. Now you are ready to come in the world, now go, whatever do. No, He holds your right hand, the Bible says. Isaiah 41:13 says, He holds your right hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you. From the moment of conception, you know, and even before that, God was with us. Even He would be with us until our death, even after the death. Because He has a plan for our life. Certainly, God was there when the world was came to be. You know, all these things you saw, God was there. When you were created separately, no one knows. Even He saw your own body, He was there. So He knows everything about you. He said that, Jeremiah 1, He said that He knows us even before the foundation of the world. He said that before I formed you in the womb, I know you. Before you were born, I set you apart. God has put you on this earth to know Him, to honor Him and to help others. God has been pursuing you or seeking you. Okay, so the clearest evidence that God loved us is that He sent His Son Jesus Christ to die, as I told you, for your sins on the cross. He did this so you would truly know Him and you would have eternal life. So our response should be in this way. In Psalm 139:17-18, it says, how precious are your thoughts about me, O God? They cannot be numbered. I cannot even count them. They outnumber the grains of sand. And I wake up, you are still with me. So we have response in that way now to God. This week to think how much God loves you. Think back, look back, how much God will take hold of you. How much you have privilege that you are to be called the son and the daughters of the creator of heaven and the earth and the king of the king, the lord of the lord. Just think what an honor we have to identify ourselves as the children of God, as the children of Yahweh. So I want you to encourage that. Sometimes you might think you seek God, but God seek you first. This is the example of Moses. God seek. He was the God who seek Moses and find him to use him for God's His glory. He found Abraham, He found Joseph, He found David, Job, Paul, and so on, so many people. God always seek first. Those people never choose God, but God choose them and call them for the better and greater purposes. I believe that He also have the greater plan for you. Though you might not see now, but just believe. This week, just let God work. Let God work. Amen.
Amen.
So does God bless you.